Welcome. In this video, we will create three new custom permissions to be leveraged with upcoming features of the RSVP list module. So far, anyone can RSVP to an event, whether a registered user or an anonymous visitor. This is because we originally configured the RSVP list module to give access to anyone who has permission to access content. To demonstrate this, I will open up my site as an anonymous user using the browser's private mode for a new session. If I navigate to the RSVP form at /RSVP list demo, hit enter, I have access to the form and I can submit it with a valid email address. To refine our module and provide more granular control over who can RSVP, let's add some custom permissions. To do this, open up your code editor with the RSVP list module loaded. Wonderful! The first thing we need to do is create the file responsible for defining permissions. In the root directory of RSVP list, create a new file called rsvplist.permissions.yaml. rsvplist.permissions.yaml. A .permissions.yaml file is used to define permissions that site administrators can use to control access to various functionality. The permissions.yaml file works in a similar manner to other YAML files you've created prior for your module, such as info.yaml or routing.yaml and links.menu.yaml, for example. There are three permissions to create: view RSVP list, access RSVP list report, and administer RSVP list. When you have created the permissions.yaml file, enter the following to create the first permission of view RSVP list. Remember, this is a YAML file, so two space indentation matters. Notice that defining permissions is straightforward. View RSVP list is the machine name of the permission. The machine names are the canonical way to refer to permissions for access checking. Put more simply, the permission machine name is the string to use when referencing the permission in code. Title is the name of the permission that is displayed on Drupal's administrative list of permissions at People Permissions. And optionally, you can provide a description for the permission, also shown on the permissions listing page. Although not shown here, the other permission attribute you can use is restrict access set to true, if you would like the site admins to know that the permission is intended for administrators only. We'll see this in the third permission we create in just a bit. To define the access RSVP list report permission, type. As you can see, it has the same structure as the view RSVP list permission above it. The final permission is administer RSVP list. Recall that we include restrict access set to true to indicate to site admins that this permission allows access to functionality intended for site administrators. Awesome! So there we have it. This is how to define custom permissions. Check your code, save the file. Nice work. Now, as an anonymous user, if we navigate back to the RSVP form on our site at /RSVP list demo, you'll see that we still have access to the form. This is because we have only defined the permissions. We have not yet used the permissions anywhere. So let's use one of the permissions. Return to your code editor and open up the rsvplist.routing.yaml file. Locate the rsvplist.formDemoRoute and change the permission it uses from accessContent to viewRSVPList. Understand that we are using the machine name of the permission to refer to it. Yes! Once you have completed this task, save the file. Then return to your site logged in as an administrator to flush the cache. So here I am at my site logged in as user 1. I'll flush the cache to have my code changes take effect. Now that it is completed, I'll open up the window as an anonymous user to see if I still have access to the form at /RSVP list demo. If I refresh the page as an anonymous user, I no longer have access. Thank you, permission system. Great. The final task of this video is to give our new permissions to the correct roles. To do this, go back to your site as an admin. Then navigate to People, then Permissions. Find the RSVP list permission set. Give the View RSVP form permission to all three roles, Anonymous, Authenticated, and Administrator. Give administrators permission to all three roles. Nice. Be sure to scroll down and save permissions. Super. In upcoming videos, we will use these permissions to control access to the RSVP form block, to the RSVP list report, and the RSVP list administrative settings. Well done. View any provided resources if you are keen. Happy learning!